Sa darating na August 31, 2020, ay magsisimula ng mag-layoff ng mga employees ang ABS-CBN. Narito ang official statement ng nasabing network. ABS-CBN Statement on Layoff of Workers, 15 July 2020. With the non-renewal of its congressional franchise, ABS-CBN is now forced to cease the operations of some of its businesses and implement a retrenchment program covering ABS-CBN and its subsidiaries effective end of business day on 31st August 2020. We are doing all we can to mitigate the pain that will be felt by those affected, including paying out separation and retirement benefits and providing job placement programs. The loss of their jobs comes at a time when the uncertain and perilous impact of the COVID-19 pandemic further makes our decision truly difficult but inevitable. As much as it hurts us to implement this retrenchment program, this is the only way to ensure the continued employment of the rest of our kapamilya. For those who are affected, we pray for you and your families that you may have the strength and guidance to deal with the challenges ahead. For all that you have done for ABS-CBN, maraming salamat po. Hindi naman nagbigay ang ABS-CBN kung ilang employees ang tatanggalin nila, pero isa na dito ay ang veteran broadcaster na si Cez Orenia Drilon. Narito ang pahayag ni Cez. "This one of the toughest days I had to face. Telling fellow kapamilyas that they would lose their jobs by end of August, I lost mine too." Nag-react din sa post na ito si Karen Davila at narito ang kanyang pahayag. At Cez Drilon, "It's been an honor to be alongside you in Bandila. You are an ABS-CBN News icon and inspiration. I am preparing my heart as well for the worst and will stand by ABS-CBN till the end." Ayon sa ilang mga sources, apektado ang mga employees at news anchors ng ABS-CBN News Channel or ANC. Nagsimulang magtrabaho si Cez sa ABS-CBN since 1989. Ayon kay Cez sa kanyang tweet, "Babangon din ang mga kapamilya. This may be our darkest hour but don't lose hope." Samantala, sa kanyang post sa Twitter, humingi din si Lea Longa ng prayers para sa mga empleyado na apektado ng pagsasara ng ABS-CBN. Narito ang kanyang tweet. "Please say a prayer for the many men and women of ABS-CBN as well as their families that they weather what might possibly be the biggest challenge of their lives. Mahigpit na yakap mga kapamilya, whether you were in favor of the shutdown or not is immaterial. Pray for them anyway. To be suddenly out of a job, it's not something to wish upon another human being, especially in the middle of this seemingly never-ending pandemic." Isang post naman sa Instagram na kung saan ay pinakita ni Corina Sanchez ang isang photo na ayon sa kanya ay ito na raw pala ang huling Christmas ID station na kanilang pagsasamahan. Narito ang post ni Corina sa Instagram. "You're hearing it correctly. So far, I guess it is a bloodbath. This family is slowly but surely being torn apart. We are called one by one. Personally, to be told that we are discontinued, not news to me. I tried to be prepared, but how can you prepare for comatose or death, really? Others taking it much harder. They have much less options and means. We help those we simply can't deny. But few can't save all. Apart from the implication on the gut, it is the heart where it tugs hardest. This episode, we have yet to see how it settles. This is and will continue to be painful. Who knew 2 years ago that this Christmas station ID would be the last time for now, that some of us originals would stand together for a joyful pose, this one to cherish for a lifetime." Samantala, pinakita ni Corina kung sino-sino ang mga kasama niya sa nasabing litrato. Narito naman ang pahayag ng isang empleyado ng ABS-CBN tungkol sa napipintong pagtatanggal ng trabahador ng nasabing network. "Losing one's job for whatever reason is a very painful experience when it happens because of unjust persecution and in this case directly inflicted by your own government and its elected officials because of selfish or political reasons, ang sakit-sakit. Many people in ABS-CBN have dedicated their entire lives to their jobs. There are many employees who, even if they receive separation pay, can't do without regular income. Many work in specialized jobs and might not find similar work. Many are no longer in the prime of their career and will find it hard to compete with younger job seekers. All have families that depend on them. There hasn't been a day that I haven't cried since the cruel decision of Congress. I cry in grief, anger, and frustration." Pati si Megastar ay meron ding sinabi. Parang sinunog ang bahay namin, parang pinatay na rin ang pamilya namin. Lalo na ang 11,000 na hindi ganun-ganun lang makakahanap ng trabaho ngayon lalo sa panahong ito. Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque mula sa interview ng CNN.